We're going to bring in now Zuhdi Jasser with the American Islamic Forum for Democracy. First to you, Zuhdi, we hear repeatedly officials calling this a tragedy. New Yorkers have it deep in the psyche of what happened with 9/11. This attack today, it's now being called, it looks like a deliberate act of terror. The suspect shouted out Allahu Akbar in around the time he was apprehended. The attack took place after 3 o'clock Eastern time. New Yorkers are pouring in their reaction to us here at Fox Business in the studio, saying it's not a tragedy, it's a disgrace. It's a despicable, detestable act. It's a disgrace. What are your thoughts?
Well, Liz, it's an act of war. We are at war. And this ideology, as much as we may feel better that ISIS is almost decimated in not only Iraq and in Syria, the ideology of jihadism will continue to spread. And these are not lone wolves. These are part of a movement of millions around the planet that believe in attacking the West, that believe if we don't live under an Islamic state, including us Muslims that are reformists and trying to counter the jihad, that we are always targets of, that we are their enemies. So ultimately, the whack-a-mole program will continue until we gather the resolve. I mean, today we saw in Congress testimony from Google and other IT experts about what they can do more on social media. And again, it's not only what we can do against jihad, but what are we doing to promote what it means to be American, what it means for Muslims to become part of this society and not hate it and not come here as enemies, but believe that this is their society, much more so than any so-called Islamic State. And we haven't even begun to do that. And I hope this not only steals our resolve, as every one of these attacks do, because you can't prevent vehicular jihad. It is almost impossible to know that when a vehicle is going to go from being on the correct side of the street to mowing over innocent pedestrians.
You know, we've got this.
Ultimately, we need a resolve.
Well, I want to get to that point in just 1 second. I need to give you this breaking news. The First Lady, Melania Trump, is tweeting out, "My heart breaks for New York City today. Thoughts and prayers as we monitor the situation." Getting back to your point about jihadi attacks using vehicles, we were tracking them. They've been about 30 to 40 of them since 1981. 80% of the attacks started really happening within the last decade. What are your thoughts about that, that the terrorists are now really, their weapon of choice is a vehicle?
Because we've squeezed them from every other point, and they will continue to find ways in which to inflict injury. The amazing statistics that I think Robin Simcox from Heritage pointed out is he pointed out that even though it's only been 7% of the attacks since 2014, it's been something like 40% of the injuries and deaths have been from vehicular jihad. And I think you need to look no further than Israel. Israel's been dealing with the first vehicular jihadists, as you said, back from the 80s and 90s. And they haven't allowed it to change their society. They haven't made it a new normal. They continue to fight it on every battlefront they can, but they will not change who they are as a democracy and as a free society. And we should also, I think, follow their example.
You know, Dr. Jasser, we're getting news coming, breaking news coming out of the White House. The Chief of Staff, General John Kelly, has debriefed the president on this terrorist attack, this disgraceful, despicable act that took the lives of 8 innocent men, all males pronounced dead at the scene, 15, maybe more, injured as people self-evacuated. We're going to stay on the injury count for our viewer. So you just mentioned just moments ago that we are only just beginning in dealing with the vehicle terror attacks. What do you mean by that?
Well, as we now have tightened the airports, we then tightened the use of arms and other things. We now, because we track them, they're now using vehicles, which are not obviously weapons, but can easily become very significant weapons. So what we need to do is realize that it's not about the gun, it's not about the vehicle, it's about the precursors to the ideology. And I hope President Trump convenes that Commission on Radical Islam he talked about during his campaign, because we cannot defeat this idea by simply waiting for them to declare their violence or declare their allegiance.
Zuhdi, I need you to, we're going to get to Tennessee Congressman Marsha Blackburn in just a second. Zuhdi, I need you to put the viewer in the mind of the terrorist, because news coming in thick and fast right now that this terrorist in this pickup truck rented from Home Depot. By the way, he was shot in the abdomen when he was apprehended with two handguns and it looked like a paint gun, paintball gun and a BB gun. He ran down bicycle riders on the on that bicycle path, which just adjoins the West Side Highway. They were riding, one, we were getting information, two individuals. One was on a city bike 50 feet away from another individual also on a city bike, and he took them both out. What is going on in the mind of this jihadi?
The jihadi, pure and simple, views Americans as infidels, as inhuman. They dehumanize us and are view themselves as soldiers who will go out as martyrs at that last moment. They see this as an avenue towards heaven, and the rest of us Muslims know that they're going elsewhere. And that they hopefully will perish in war, and their entire movement will perish. But we have to declare war on their ideology. And what they've done is through many media globally, not only on social media, but Al Jazeera and elsewhere, have glorified Islamism, have glorified the ideas that are the precursors to demonizing us in America. So what goes through their mind is the sense that this society is ungodly, it's anti-Islam. So they want to act as jihadists. And we'll do anything that we obviously perceive as what it is, which is barbaric and inhuman.
This is a despicable act. It is disgusting, and it's a disgrace. And, sir, jihadis have declared war on fellow Muslims, correct? The final thought.
Absolutely. You know, this is the untold story, is that in Iraq and Syria and in across the Middle East and in Europe and in America, we Muslims that are fighting this, that have declared a jihad on jihad, are the first ones at the head of the spear. We need to begin to fight this in the consciousness, not only on the battlefront, which is a whack-a-mole program, if we don't fight the consciousness that Islam is in its time. As Christians now celebrate 500 years of the Reformation of Martin Luther, Islam needs to start going through that Reformation if we're ever going to see an end to this war.